Ezreal has cleared out of our sector.
Investigate for intel. investigate anything that seems useful.
What are you doing?
What does it look like I'm doing? I'm fishing. Can't an old man just fish in peace these days?
My apologies. So, the, fish biting today?
Yes, but most fishermen lack the imagination to see what I'm fishing for.
And just what is it that you're fishing for?
While others are fishing for food, I'm fishing for wonder. Being out here reminds me of my childhood. My brothers and I used to pretend we were catching the Big One, a legendary creature from the ancients. As I grew up, I learned about a secret ritual that could help me catch it and become the best fisherman in the world. I believe this is the last creature of its kind, and I'm going to be the one to catch it. Say, do you know what might make fishing here a little easier for someone of my advanced age?
Nope. What's that?
Legend says that in order to catch the Big One, I need a special fishing lure. I don't seem to have enough metal scraps to make a good one.
Okay. So where can I find these metal scraps you need?
The very best scraps, the metal that is easiest to work with, is found around where the settlers live. I suppose those vestiges of the Cold War might have something too.
Well, you know what they say. Give a man a fish and you'll feed him for a day. Teach a man to fish and you fed him for a lifetime. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you kindly. When you return, I'll tell you the story of the Big One.
Keep your eyes open for any intel. We need to gather any intel we can find.
Thank you for the metal scraps. They'll make for a great lure. Haven't had one since I was young.
No problem.
When I was young, my brothers and I used to follow in the footsteps of the ancients. We saw so much beauty on this island, but also much ugliness. Speaking of which, have you heard of the old gold mines?
The old gold mines? I might have, but what do you know about them?
Well, the lure itself is not enough. The mines are filled with as much gold as the riverbeds are filled with jade. I will need them both for the wobbler. The luster will draw the big one out. I'm sure of it.
I guess even legendary fish are tempted by shiny objects.
That's more true than you know. Could you bring me some gold from one of the mines and jade from one of the riverbeds?
That shouldn't be a problem. Should I meet you back here?
No. Lake Mary doesn't need us anymore. Meet me at Whaler's Bay Province, north of Behemoth Passage, south of Small Valley. I have a site there.
That sure sounds like a riddle.
My sacred site, I assure you, is no laughing matter.
Chopper cleared out of here. We're good now.
stash with you, copy? This is Nomad. I can receive traffic on Cyclops.
Lima Charlie, Nomad. Your target is Boris Govoretsky. Cyclops is a bodark that supervises the new stealth tech for drones. Believes in an all-powerful Russian empire. His location is unknown, but my inside source on the island intercepted a civilian distress call that indicated Cyclops was tracking them down. I'll send over the coordinates.
Got it. Need to figure out what the nut job wants with them. Nomad out. Desecrated flag. Nobody who fought so hard for their country should have ever been driven to this. I can't even imagine how betrayed he must have felt to do this.
The places you've gone, the things you've seen, it's tragic, isn't it? My grandfather said that all Shira wanted to do was stop running, but he could never escape himself.
This guy fought too hard for far too long.
There has to be a better way than ritual suicide.
It was a different time, a different culture. From his point of view, it was probably the best thing to do.
This is not the kind of honor my grandfather taught me.
Listen, as soldiers, we have an obligation to protect those who can't protect themselves. We're honor-bound to do the right thing, even if it means sacrificing ourselves to do it. And as long as I stay true to my path, as long as I stay true to who I am, I won't follow in the Shiro's footsteps. I'm my own man. But the lessons that these men learned, they won't be forgotten. Looks like you've been real busy. How'd you learn to make these lanterns?
My grandfather taught me how to make them when I was a child. I remember scraps of colored paper, cookies, and sunlit afternoons.
That's touching.
Yes. Those are some of my fondest memories of him. There was only us and these lanterns. The rest of the world just fell away.
This new world must look real different for someone who was born and raised here.
It happened so quickly. Innovation, they say. But this progress feels like a train blasting down the tracks.
Yeah, or careening off a cliff.
Yes.
So what do you think they want here? Those soldiers?
Opportunists are always attracted to shiny objects.
So you're not too fond of them?
Have you ever seen tree rot? A tree can look fine on the outside, but be completely decayed inside. Those soldiers are an infestation.
Do you believe it, though? That scientists can change the world?
I have no ambitions to change the world. Just to protect my corner of it. And my grandfather's memory.
Your grandfather had an interesting view of things.
My grandfather called it Bushido, the warrior's path. It was the code of honor developed by ancient samurai.
Tell me more.
It always is when you ascribe to a staunch moral code. But that was also the point. You can easily devote your life to fulfilling those standards.
And what use were they to him?
Bushido taught him how to act, how to live until the very end. He did horrible things, but those values helped him atone. They're really valuable if you don't take them too far. I do my best to live up to that legacy.
I can respect that.
My grandfather told me
I can respect that. Good luck.
Thanks. You too.